fireworks are art, and what we're going for isn't necessarily the blast, but what that blast produces, beautiful colors, sound effects. We use different chemicals to be able to create the different effects that we want it to be, you know? So like we have different effects that'll make crackle. We have different effects that'll make it bright and yellow or bright and blue. You mix different chemicals together to ultimately get the effect that you're going for. And it's the process of kind of pulling it all together that you'll ultimately create what are called stars. And stars are those pyrotechnic effects that have been rolled in certain chemicals. They end up as kind of, if you can imagine, little balls. And those end up like pixels in the sky. You know, like when you're looking at fireworks and you see the individual lights coming down. Those are what we call stars. And you make those by hand. It's important to note, every firework out there, everything is made by hand.
So are they pretty standard in the sense that, like, look, this is a math calculation at the end of the day, and if we put this mm-hmm. much in at this, it is going to do exactly yep. this, or can they be unpredictable?
It's not 100% a formula. It's art and science, but roughly for about every inch of caliber, it's roughly about 100 feet a burst, meaning it'll go 100 feet wide, it'll go 100 feet in the air, and it'll take a second to get there. So roughly, let's say like an 8-inch shell, which would be a fairly large 4th of July production shell that we would use, that'll roughly go about 800 feet wide. It'll take 8 seconds to apex, and it'll go about 800 feet in the air, roughly.
Now, when it's go time, right? Like, is somebody sitting there like, all right, light the match, or is it basically computerized at this point?
There are three ways of being able to shoot pyro. You can physically go out and light it, which many people still do. But then really with our company and other companies in the industry, they really kind of started to advocate for the safe presentation of this, where instead of lighting it by hand, where you're putting yourself physically near the fireworks itself, you can shoot these things electronically, where essentially you can put a firing system sometimes, you know, hundreds of feet away or even further, and then be able to shoot it remotely. In the case of something detrimental happening, you're not putting that specific operator at physical risk. And currently, for our company, with very few exceptions, almost everything is shot electronically in that way. Now, in the 21st century, we shoot things digitally. And for our many of our shows now, we're shooting them electronically, but they're being computer shot. And that really kind of allowed us to be able to do things with much tighter choreography, where we can choreograph the effects and the time that those effects go up in the sky to be able to produce fireworks shows that are cued specifically to music. And so when you see, you know, again, like the 1812 Overture, and you hear the cannon fire going, you know, that cannon fire occurring is occurring at the same time we're shooting pyro in the air, and it's perfectly synced up.
So in my mind, right, like, are these basically just big black cats in the sense that, like, all right, this is basically just an upscaled version of the firework stuff that you buy at the tent, or is this a fundamentally different thing?
Yeah, great question. So with respect to the pyro that we're shooting, we have two major classifications, three technically, but really in production, there's two major classifications. It actually comes from the Department of Transportation. We have 1.3 and we have 1.4. And 1.3 is aerial pyrotechnics, which is non-consumer. These are, I want to point out, they're not high explosives. They're normal explosive devices. It's not like C4. It's not like det cord or something like that. These are artistic effect. And it's important to note that fireworks are art, and what we're going for isn't necessarily the blast, but what that blast produces, beautiful colors, sound effects, things of this nature. And those fireworks are designed for that. But aerial fireworks, which is the 1.3, which is the stuff we're typically dealing with here, you know, your consumer should never handle those. I'm not going to say that they're unsafe, but they do require particular training and safety awareness to be able to work correctly. And they also require, in almost all instances, a mortar, which, again, most consumers are not going to have. But these shells are, they're fundamentally different in terms of how they operate. And they're typically single thing. Like, you might end up getting a fountain or a cake or something like that from a consumer grade that might have lots of different effects in it. Our effects are single purpose, you know, so it's like a, you know, let's say 5-inch red dahlia, or it might be a, you know, 3-inch red, white, blue peony, but it does one thing and one thing only.